Hello, my pretty and lovely friends. This time I thought to make a video on something very informative and knowledgeable. Yeah, you got it. The topic is, what are the process or steps involved to coming to a foreign or a new country? So for explaining this, I will take an example of USA or United States of America and let you know about all the details in a very extensive way. If you are traveling to abroad for the first time, all this information will really be helpful for you. So let's not waste the time and get started. A passport is a travel document usually issued by a country's government that certifies the identity and nationality of its holder for the purpose of international travel. In a very simple way, countries would like to have an organized accounting of people leaving and entering their territories. Passports are an official document one citizen is required to have, issued only by a internationally recognized government of your area. Usually a Foreign Affairs, Home Office or State Department is the typical government agency tasked to design, develop and deploy an official document which their citizen can use to ID themselves when applying for visa or entering to another country. Citizens, when they apply for a passport, they need to prove that they are citizens of said country by birth or acquired citizenship. Several documents are required to be issued a passport. Your passport is not just registered in your country but also in another international database shared only among governments. There are three types of Indian passports, which are: regular passport has a navy blue color and is issued for ordinary travel such as vacations, jobs and business trip. Diplomatic passport has a maroon cover and is issued to Indian diplomats, top ranking governments, officials and diplomatic careers. Official passport has a white cover and it is issued to individual representing the Indian government on official business. In this page, you will get the options of existing user, new user, track application status and check application. Applying for the passport first time, you can click on the new user. You can also click on others if that applies too. After clicking on new user, fill the information and click on register button. After filling the registration form, you will get the link in your email ID after 20 or 25 minutes to activate your account. Click on the link which you get on your Gmail ID and start login. After logging, you will get varieties of options to click. Click on your related part, like if you are applying for fresh or renewal passport, click on fresh. If you are applying for minor, click on minor, etc., etc. Finished clicking on your passport type, come to that next page called applicant details, and in this page you have to fill all the necessary information related to your document. After filling all the information, click on save my details and come to the next page. After completing passport type and applicant details, come to that next part, that is family details. Fill all the information, then save my details and come to the next page is present residential address. Fill all the columns, save my details and come to the next. To the next page, emergency contact. Fill all the information, click on save my details and come to the next. Next page is for references. You can put the name of your guardian, relatives and close friends. Then save my details and come to the next page. Previous passport page is for existing lost or damaged identity certificate. If it relates to you, fill the blank, and if it's not, click the no section and come to the next page. Next page is other details. Click on the no or yes button after reading the information and then click on the next button. Now you will reach to the second last page called passport detail verification. Please note that fill your passport form very carefully as it is going to print in your passport. Last page is self-declaration page. In this page, click on yes button if you wish to enroll for passport seva SMS services, as this is a one-time enrollment charges for passport seva SMS services. Then click on submit button. After submitting your form, you will get to see three options: pay and schedule appointment, print application receipt, upload supporting documents. As you are a fresh applicant, click on pay and schedule appointment. You can pay online by internet banking, debit card or credit card. You can also pay by challan payment, pay in a cash at SBI branch. After completing this online transaction, click to next and come to the next page. Schedule appointment page, you will get to know about Passport Seva Kendra, their dates of availability and in which city it is going to be held. Now you will come under the page pay and book appointment. Pay the fee 1500 online or in the bank. If you want to choose another date, select a date on another appointment date column. Click on payment. You will get to see the options of bank and their charges. Just click on bank which you wish to choose and pay for the appointment on respected date. So now let's talk about the type of documents you need for your passport on the day of appointment on your PSK. For the fresh, tatkal, lost and damaged passport, all the documents will be same as written in the fresh passport section, except few new documents are more needed for the damaged passport. On the appointment date, applicant have to arrive slightly early and wait for their turn. After entering to your Passport Seva Kendra, you will be subjected to a security check and then enter a pre-process area. There, applicant will be issued with a token number. Your token number arrived on the display. Go to the designated counter wherein citizen service executive upload the customer document onto the Passport Seva system. Your photograph, fingerprint will also be taken. Fee would be collected if it has not already been paid before, and personal details in the system will be printed and given to the applicant for verification and signature, which would then be uploaded into the system. Now the applicant has to move to the next counter where a verification officer will check all the documents thoroughly again, and then applicant have to wait to enter the next counter. Once the applicant has entered to the another counter, a granting officer will take a call on whether all processes have been completed properly and if the passport can be granted or not. After this, applicant will have to head to the exit counter. Applicant will receive an acknowledgement letter from the exit counter. This document will have to be maintained carefully as it can be used to track the application status. Individual must note that in case the application form has been successfully submitted and the final status is granted, the printing of passport would be done in case of no or post police verification. If the status given in pre-police verification, the passport would be printed after a police report has been provided. The key points to remember is that minor applicants can present address proof document in the name of their parents. Second, if the applicant is submitting only ration card, election card, Aadhaar card as the address proof, it must be supported with another address proof. Third, if the applicant is born after 26-1-1989, birth certificate is mandatory. Fourth, if annexure H must be submitted if the applicant is a minor. Fifth, annexure B and M must be submitted if the applicant is a government employee. The purpose of your intended travel and other facts will determine what type of visa is required under US immigration law. As a visa applicant, you will need to establish that you meet all requirements to receive the category of visa for which you are applying. There are 100 or more than that of US visa. A few of them are necessary to know. So let's know the most common type of visa, which are B1, J1, H1, H2, L1, H4 and visitor visa. So in this segment, you will know about how to apply for US visa. Step 1. Determine your visa type by reading common non-immigrant visas. Each visa type explains the qualifications and applications item. Be sure to review the visa waiver program. If your country participates in this program, you do not need to apply for a visa. Next step is to complete the non-immigrant visa electronic applicant DS-160 form. Be sure to read the guidelines for completing the DS-160 form carefully. All information must be correct and accurate. Once the form is submitted, you cannot make any changes. Once you have determined the correct visa type and completed the DS-160 form, you must pay the visa fee. You can pay your fee through National Electronic Fund Transfer called NEFT, mobile payment or cash over the counter at Druk PNB Bank Limited or over the Axis or Citibank. You will create a profile and must keep your receipt number to book your visa appointment. In the next step, you are almost ready to schedule your visa appointment. You must schedule two appointments, one for the visa application center and another for the visa interview at the embassy or consulate. First, schedule your appointment at a visa application center. This appointment will allow you to go to one of the five visa application center location of your choice to have your fingerprint and photo taken. This appointment must be at least one day before your visa interview appointment at the embassy or consulate. Second, schedule your visa interview appointment at the embassy or consulate. You will need three things of the information in order to schedule your appointment. First, your passport number, then the visa application fee receipt number, and the third, the 10-digit barcode number from your DS-160 confirmation page. In the next step for a visa application center appointment, you will need to bring a passport valid for travel to the United States with the validity date at least 6 months beyond your intended period of stay in the United States. And then you have to bring your DS-160 confirmation page, your appointment confirmation page, and your photograph. After following your visit to the visa application center to have your photo and fingerprints taken, you will then visit to the US embassy or consulate on the date and time of your visa interview. You will need to bring a printed copy of your appointment confirmation letter, your DS-160 confirmation page stamped at the visa application center, your current and old passport. If you have old passport, then you can take. And then supporting document as per your visa type. Application without all these documents will not be accepted. So guys, this is the today's segment. I hope you all would like this video. And guys, please don't forget to subscribe, like, share and comment to my channel Reflection of Beauty for more informative video. And from the next week onwards, we will going to have 2 videos every week. Bye bye. Take very good care of yourself.